Hi guys, this is Gadgetman 404 and this is a show and tell of the build of my FreeX Skyview quadcopter. As you may or may not be aware, I had a massive malfunction. This was over a month ago now. It basically was wobbling, like oscillating as soon as it took off, like this. And then it just went off. It went over some trees, and I knew that over these particular trees was a big field. There's a lake over to that direction, and trees and trees and trees over there, and trees and trees and trees over there. And I saw it go over and down the trees, so I thought it was over these trees. But basically what had happened was, as it went over the tree line and then came down so I couldn't see it anymore, it was flying to the left. And it flew nearly a mile and a half away, and I had no control. My FPV had gone, my FPV feed had gone as well at that point. So I had no idea where it was, and I honestly thought I'd lost it. So I went looking for days and days and days, and I didn't find it. And then I rang the police station, thanks to one of my subscribers said I've contacted the police. And I thought to myself, well, no, actually I haven't. So I thought, well, I'll ring the police and report a missing drone. And then the same day, this was like a week, nearly a week after though, I got a phone call back from the police to say that they had a drone found. I needed to give them some descriptions of my drone and what colour was it and what did I have on it, something specific that I couldn't just lie and say, oh, it's white, because particularly most drones are white. And basically it was my drone, and as you guys may or may not have seen in the videos, it was completely smashed to hell. You know, the rear arm was cracked off, that arm was cracked off, the legs were snapped off. Massive crack down here. This motor was missing altogether at the front. The front right motor had gone. And I think the only motor arm that wasn't broken was the front left. So I didn't want to go buying a new shell until I tested all the components. So that's why I did this build. Now, my wife got me a DIY drone guide book for Christmas, and it shows you how to build your own drone. And I looked in there, and actually it had drones on wooden frames, but the motors were way bigger than mine. So I didn't even know if, with the weight ratio and everything else, if this would even fly. But as you guys have seen the video, it absolutely flies fine. I'm just gonna try and do auto. I'm trying to zoom in. I just don't know how you do this blooming camera. I don't know how you zoom in with it. I'll have to do manual. Yeah, there you go. So this arm, as I say, that arm was completely cracked off, and so was that arm. That arm was actually whole, and that motor at the front was completely missing. Now luckily I'd bought a motor thinking, when I had a fault with it a while ago, I bought a motor and I'd actually purchased the wrong motor, and when I had to send it to China to be repaired, they I said, don't change that motor, because that motor's brand new. They'd already changed it, but they sent it back. It cost me like 30 quid, that motor did. Dead expensive. And I wanted to test all the components out first before I purchase a new shell at £30 to £40 if I get a DJI shell, because I was thinking of putting this in a DJI shell, like a Phantom, a Vision 2 or a Standard 3, the ones where you can fit a separate gimbal underneath. I think the Vision 2 is that kind of a one. And but I wanted to test this out to see if there was any damage to the electronics. And as you guys have seen the actual the flight I did last week, and it flies. You know, Frankenstein monster lives again. The FreeX is on a bit of plywood. It cost me a pound for a big sheet of plywood, and cost me 50p for these arms that was in one length, and I just asked them to shave and cut them into, like, I don't know, 10 inch sections, whatever. Then I adjusted them accordingly when I got them home. So I've got, as you can see, I'm just getting in close there. Focus. Right, let me try and do this manually. So autofocus. I don't know how you bloody do this thing. What's that? 1 minute. No, I don't know how you get autofocus to work on this camera. This is my son's Sony camera. It's like a wicked, wicked camera. But it's not touchscreen, so I can't, like I can with my phone, I can just touch it and it'll do what it needs to do. But that is just double-sided foam tape to space the gap between the board. As you can see, the board and the arms leave a gap, and the ESC would be down here, but it has to be on the top of the actual board. So I put some double-sided tape there to space that out. They're bolted underneath. It goes through to the bottom of the motor. Again, autofocus isn't working, so forget that. And so now that's really rigid and doesn't move. These are Phantom style props. They're not real Phantoms. They cost like £3 for four or whatever from some internet site. And I needed to mount the GPS module. Now, the module normally is mounted on the inside of the top shell with that piece sticking up and then obviously looking down. And I didn't have a GPS like the folding arms that you can buy for the metal kind of folding drones. So I built one with stuff I had at home. So my GPS module holder, if you like, is an upside down yogurt pot with a pencil and a back of an old transmitter and then double-sided tape. It's hot glued inside the pot, it's hot glued to the top. I made a hole in this thing. There's double-sided sticky tape at the bottom of the pencil, and that is onto the board, and I've got double-sided tape on four sides to anchor it down to the actual flight control board. And as you can see, it's very sturdy. I'm picking it up, look, all that weight. There's a camera and everything on there. So it's well and truly on there. It's not going anywhere. The sort of the mini USB, not the micro because it's old, so the mini USB where you can connect it to the computer, run peripheral software to change the parameters of the height when you return to home, the speed which you return to home, and so on and so on. That has always been a bit dodgy, and now it sort of, it works if I manually plug in the dongle to reset the gyros, but when I'm trying to connect it to the computer and I'm flipping the switches on the transmitter, it's not actually correlating that information. So the settings aren't changing, but I think it's just this that is dodgy. It always has been. Or it's the dongle itself that's dodgy, so I could buy either a new one of these or a new dongle. That's what I'll look into. As I say, GPS module is mounted there very, very well. I have also got FPV on this bad boy. So I've got the AKK B2, an all-in-one solution. 5.8 gigahertz, 40 channel, works off a 1S battery, and you've got a little button that you press and you hold it for so many seconds and it flips through the bands and the channels, etc. I've got my KitVision Edge HD10 camera underneath. That is a 1080p camera at 30 frames, 720 at 60, and it goes VGA and WGA and all that kind of thing. This is one of the aerial antennas. Now, on the original frame, this ran down the inside of one of the legs, and then this one was actually on the side of the body. Now, when I did a flight the other day, I had them both mounted to here, and I didn't get very far range, and it was wobbling and acting up all over the place. So I must have been having them together got interference, and now I've got them going as far away from each other as I can. I could even move this one a little bit across here, but then it might get in the way of the camera. I'm going to put I might do another half inch this way, and then put a cable tie through the slash going all the way down, and then have this mounted to the outside edge of the cable tie, so then it shouldn't get caught in the view of the camera. Just to hold the camera on for today and for the first flight, I've just got some elastic band really tight going round the frame, going round the camera, around the FPV monitor, well, the FPV camera, and I've got a piece of foam that I've doubled up, so that gives me a bit of an angle. There's foam that folds at the back of the computer, back of the camera, when my battery is mounted, and let's just turn this round. So how I'm done that is basically double-sided foam tape, stick the battery to that, push it as far forward as I can. I now can sort of mess around with the CG. So if I have my heavier camera and my heavier battery, I can have the battery a little bit further back, and then the camera can be a little bit underneath the frame. When I've got my lighter camera, then obviously I can have the battery mounted as far forward as I can, and I can actually push the camera a little bit forward as well, so it lips a little bit at the top. That's, I can get to the button a lot easier to switch it on and press record. That's it really, guys. I have fitted a mini OSD. It isn't the FreeX version, so I'm having issues with getting that installed. I've installed it onto the flight control board, and I've got a transmitter upstairs, but I haven't got a separate camera, like a free camera set up yet. So I need to get another little camera, and I can hook the wires from the OSD to the camera and then mount the camera to the transmitter. And then I will get satellites, direction, battery strength, etc, etc. Because I know when this hits 10.8 volts, it should be 11.1, but I changed it to 10.8, it now does, it will automatically do a return to home. When this returns to home, guys, the FreeX always flies backwards, but you can rotate the quad as you're flying. It will take out a GPS hold just for that split second to do the maneuver, so face it to you, and then it will continue to do the return to home. And then that way, with the FPV camera at the front, you can see if there's buildings or high trees or branches or pylons or whatever in your way, then you can get out the way, basically. And this is a FPV camera that just works off a 1S battery, or actually I'm using it a 2S. I'm using one of my Hobson H502E batteries. I think it works off a single cell or a 2S, and a 2S 700 milliamp or 610 milliamp will give me a lot longer flight times. And I would love to go out flying today, but I can't because it's chucking it down. But the little bit of sort of twitching that I got last week, I think it's these arms are too deep. Look, I only need about a quarter of an inch deeper than the actual camera base, and then I'm going to make them a lot thinner. I'm going to half the width, so then they're not going to catch the wind so much. Not so much when the wind's coming from the side, because they're quite thin, but when it comes from the other angle, then obviously they act like a bit like a sail, and the wind can blow it round a little bit. But this is my look and my build of the FreeX Skyview quadcopter. I will be testing it more, quite a bit more, before I invest in a shell until I'm completely satisfied that that issue will not happen again. I'll keep it on this frame because, like I say, £1.50 to replace the wood is a better, is a lot cheaper and more affordable than, you know, £30 to £40 for a new shell. So thanks for subscribing. I know this is a bit long, but please, I do appreciate you guys watching my videos. Thanks for all the comments, all the positive feedback that I had when I was looking for my quad, telling me, you'll find it. And I did, so thank you guys. Yeah, you kept me looking. I did think it was gone, but I didn't want it to be lost. I wanted to find it, and I continue to look for it. So for that, guys, I can say and only say thanks a lot. Also, I just want to thank all you guys for subscribing to me. I'm nearly at 400 subscribers. I'm never going to make any money out of this because they've changed all the rules. I can't monetize my videos now, but that's not the end of the world. I'm not that bothered about that. Just do a manual zooming. That's it. So my little FPV camera's there. That's the, not that that is the receiver. Flight control board is under there. That is a GPS module on top. ESCs and motors and propellers. These are cheap clone Phantoms, but they work. You know, thanks for subscribing. I'm going to mount a GPS tracker to this and eventually somehow to whatever quadcopter I get. So if I do get in the situations that I had the other day, then I will be able to find it. And all you do is you put a 2G SIM card in, you ring the number to that SIM card, it then sends you a text message with a link with a map of Google Earth, and then with the GPS location switched on your handset and your internet access, you can trace your quadcopter. And mine flew over a mile away when it went out of control. I did do return to home, it didn't return to home. I have done return to home since with this now, and it is returning to home. It is rising and returning to home. So I hope I fixed all the little glitches. I can still tweak it. Thinner, shorter arms, move them aerials further apart so there's no interference there. And that's it really. And hopefully I will get this in a shell, but I do like this form factor actually. It's just a bit big. But yeah, for now guys, thanks for the ride. Thanks for subscribing to me. Continue to subscribe. Guys, click the bell icon on the YouTube, you know, near the subscribe. So then when I do upload stuff, you will be in the loop and you'll get notified when that happens. So for now, Gadget Man 404 out.
Thanks for watching Gadget Man 404's channel.